Welcome everyone from UTOPS Directory. A special welcome to those of you who are worshipping this way for the first time, and a special welcome to those who have journeyed with us for some time. I hope you feel fully part of this online worshipping community today as we worship God together. As we gather here together today, we understand afresh God's love for each of us and for all people. At the beginning of this Christian Aid Week, we seek to be inspired anew by God's transforming vision for our world, made possible by God's love for us and our love for each other. We start our worship by singing together, "Praise to the Holiest in the Height."
Thank you.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God invites us who thirst to come to the waters, we who are hungry to find food without price, yet we look elsewhere for satisfaction. In the search to find satisfaction for ourselves, we ignore the hunger and thirst of many, locally and around the world. We have not drawn close to know God's love for us. Lord, have mercy. We have not recognised God's love for all people, each one a beloved child of God. Christ, have mercy. With our limited imagination, we have not grasped God's vision for a world where all will flourish. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The first reading is from the first letter of John, chapter 5, verses 1 to 6. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ, not with the water only, but with the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit is the truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit. Fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We continue this week with the second part of chapter 15 found in the Gospel of John. And once again, we hear the call to abide with God as God abides with us. Once again, we hear about the power and freeing nature of God's love. Once again, we hear about how we as the communities of faith are supposed to interact, support, and love one another. Once again, we hear the call to love one another. It is a hard lesson for us humans to hear, to learn and to live out in our lives, this call to love one another as Jesus loves us, to bear fruit that lasts in a world that is starving for good news, to fully abide with God by sharing God's love for all through our actions and deeds. Maybe John thought we needed to hear this message again. Maybe John thought his community needed to hear this word of love once more, especially after his own community, a new community of faith, a beginning church, was already arguing and bickering, was already struggling with the command to abide in God by showing God's love to one another. And maybe just like his community, our world, our community, needs to hear this word of love once more, especially now when nothing in life seems stable and secure. Jobs are being lost. We hear reports about institutions that have been around for ages, struggling to survive. And as we emerge from our restrictions, we will find our high streets looking very different as many of the stores have closed. We turn to the institution of the church for a firm foundation, only to find that churches are closing their doors, or we find that many churches are struggling with what it means to serve in a changing world. There is a sense of instability and insecurity that has invaded and penetrated every aspect of our lives. And we are looking for something to cling to, something to grasp, to give us security, something to give us strength and encouragement until this storm passes, something to help us find our feet again and give us a firm and solid foundation. And for John and for us, that something is each other. That something is a community of faith that loves us and supports us. That something that will give us strength and encouragement is a community grounded and connected to each other, relying on one another, supporting one another, loving each other as God loves. A community that knows that it cannot do it alone, that like the branches connected to the vine, it is so intertwined that one cannot tell where one starts and one stops. It's very easy to fall into the trap of seeing our lives in two parts, the church world and the real world. For me, however, I have come to realise that there is only the one world that I am called to live in as a person of faith, and that I am called to reflect God's love in all that I do and all that I say. I've come to realise that I can't divide God's love to fit my needs or my wants. God's love just doesn't work that way. God loves us. The good, the bad, the ugly, the successful, the poor, the young, the old, and all those in between. And since I am connected to that person or this person through God's love, I am responsible for that person. I'm called to look out for that person's good. I'm called to support that person in this world, whether I like them or not. I'm called to love them as Jesus loves me, and called to bear fruit that lasts as a result of that love. What a great lesson in faith. What a humbling lesson in faith. But what a hard lesson in faith to live out in our lives, to love as Jesus loves. That's why John repeats himself. That's why John keeps repeating the commandment to love one another as the Father has loved us. That is why John keeps saying that there is no greater love than God's love for us, and we are called to bear the fruit that lasts as a result of God's love in our lives. Jesus came and through his death showed us how much God truly loves us. Jesus came and chose us, people who are imperfect, people who are broken, people who are very much human, to tell this world the good news. Jesus came and invited us to abide in God, just as God abides in us. And John is reminding us that we are called to live in this world, this broken, hurting world, and to love kindness, make justice, and to walk humbly with our God. That all our actions, all our words, must be rooted in one commandment: love one another as Jesus loves us. We're called to love as Jesus loves us, and we know that this love is life-changing. There's no divide between church world and real world. There is only one world, and this world will know us by our love for one another. Because it is our love for another, not as we love ourselves, but as God loves us, that will be the most convincing witness to the truth and power of the gospel message that we proclaim. We've experienced God's love in our lives. We've experienced the power of God's love in our lives. We have experienced the sacrifice of God's love in our lives and have been humbled and changed by this experience. We have the ultimate example. Jesus' actions provide the pattern by which we are to act towards one another. We're called to show this world that they will know we are Christians by our love. We are called to show God's love through our actions and our deeds in everything that we do. We are called to bear fruit that lasts and will satisfy this hungry, broken world. God first loved us, and that love is never ending. And because God sees us and knows us and still loves us, we can dare to see ourselves, know ourselves, and accept ourselves as we are known and forgiven and loved. And it's out of this life-transforming love that we're called to love each other, to bear each other, to build each other up, to stay with each other. And it is this life-changing love that forms the basis of our lives as Christians. Our lives are changed by God's love. And this cannot stay only between two people or behind the doors of a church building. This love drives us, urges us, inspires us to go out into our communities and to share God's love with all that we meet. May we strive to love one another as Jesus loves us, and to live out this love in all that we say and all that we do. Amen.
You.
The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Saviour. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death, and so we gladly thank you with saints and angels praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. As we receive communion, we do so on behalf of you all. We do so in the hope of that day soon when we can receive communion together. And as we do so, I invite you to receive a spiritual communion now with Jesus, our Lord, who loves us and abides in us. The body of Christ. Amen. The blood of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ.
on the blood of Christ. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, whose Son Jesus Christ gives the water of eternal life, may we thirst for you, the spring of life and source of goodness, through him who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. We are the beloved children of God. As the branches are to the vine, so we are to Christ. May we go out rejoicing in God's love, spreading that love wherever we go this week. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Till all